One, two, three, four. Blues fans, this is Anthony from Texas Blues Alley. It's time for Free Lesson Friday. It feels good to be back. First one of 2015. To start off this year's batch of lessons, we're going to look at one of my favorite, the most raucous blues song that I can think of. This is Give Me Back My Wig, written by Hound Dog Taylor, covered by Stevie Ray Vaughan and others, I assume. And at first, the rhythm seems pretty simple. Just taking the upper triad of a E form chord and sliding this one note up. But as I was researching this, I realized there's a little bit of magic in there to make it have that kind of greasy sound. So I'm going to take a look at that. And then I'll also explain to you why if you try and play it like you see Stevie playing it, it's going to sound wrong because he did a thing with his G string to make this work better for slide. But we'll talk about that later. I will mention that if you belong to our TXBA Locals membership program, you will have the interactive sound slice tablature with this lesson over at Texas Blues Alley. Let's get right into it. One, two, three, four. So we're in the key of E using standard tuning here. The rhythm that we're going to be playing, I'll show you the full chord, but it's based off of the sound of taking the open B string. So if you just start with that, the pattern that you want to think of is 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay? So it's important that you get that kind of cadence down. You come in with two strong beats, then move up to the next note. One, two, three, four, and then up to the third note. One, two, and then back down again. Okay, now I'm going to show you one more little embellishment to throw in before we add in the rest of the notes of the chord. When you do your four hits here, before you jump up here, throw in a slide. Okay, that little slide is kind of what gives it that greasy feel. Now, if you just want to add in one more string, you can get the top E string in there with it. But again, to get the full sound, you want to throw in the third note, which in this case, because we're standard tuning, is going to be the G string at the first fret. Okay, now this is a 12-bar blues progression, so after you do four bars on the one, you're going to slide up to the fifth fret and play the same thing over the four. And then back down to the one. Now it gets interesting when we go to the five chord because we do a little bit of fiddly stuff to give it a little bit more magic. Hear that? Okay, so let me just show you what we're doing here. We're sliding in. Sliding in along the G string up here to the be the 8th fret. So slide in, pick the top E string and the B string together. Space. Hear that rest in there? And then you're just pulling off from 9 to 7 on the E, down to 7 on the B. It's important that you get that rest in there. And then. Two hits with your pinky on the 10th fret of the B string. And then our four hits with it back to 9. Okay, that just dresses up the 5 chord a little bit, makes it sound a little bit more funky. Then we just drop back to the 4, do the same thing that we did before. Back down to the 1. This is an example of a song that does not have a turnaround at the end of the 12-bar progression. What this means is that it gets kind of confusing if you play two choruses of just the rhythm in a row, because you have the 2 bars at the end on the 1 and then the 4 bars at the beginning. It's 6 bars all on the 1 chord without any demarcation between the choruses. So what you usually have happen is if there is a chorus of just this rhythm, as soon as they get to the end, then somebody will come in for singing or the solo will start. All right, so let's talk about what you can do if you want to incorporate some slide. So I first saw this when I was watching Stevie play the outro, and before he played this song, I saw him reach down and he tuned his G string up a half step so that it would form a major triad. What happens when you do that is now you no longer need to fret this note. You can just play them all open. So now when you get up here, instead of playing that triad like that, you would just bar it with your index finger, and then you can either use the grip, bar it this way and slide your ring finger, or you can just traditional thumb behind. And it makes the it doesn't have a whole lot of effect on what you play with the fives. Just remember you're barring this instead of holding that note there. Now again, I mentioned they would do this. When people would do this, it would be so that when they're singing, "Give me back my wing," so that they could play this slide. And so I think most of the time when you do this, you're just ignoring these lower strings. I'm not a slide player. This is about all I can do. Okay, so it allows you to do that rhythm pattern and still slide up here to play slide. So, if you're not playing slide, just keep it in standard tuning. Like I was showing you before. So that's the rhythm for Give Me Back My Wig. It's one of my favorite raucous blues rhythms. It shows what you can do with just a few simple chords and some good syncopation. So pay really close attention to that 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4 with that little slide. Because that little slide is one of those polished bits that makes the whole thing sound a little bit more professional. Anyway, until next time, thanks for watching.